When you saw the movie Surrogates, you said, well, that's science fiction when Bruce Willis has a mechanical robot who is perfect, absolutely perfect, handsome with superpowers, and you put your consciousness into the robot. So you go into a pod, your body ages, your body is strapped to a pod, but you mentally control an avatar, a surrogate who has superpowers, perfectly formed, and has all your abilities. This sounds like science fiction, right? Or the movie Avatar, where again, you're put inside a pod and you control an alien being on another planet breathing poisonous air. Is that possible? The answer is definitely yes. In Japan, scientists at Honda Corporation has made a robot called Asimo. It's one of the most advanced robots ever made. Asimo, the size of a young boy, can run, walk, climb up stairs, and even dance. In fact, he dances better than me. I've been on science specials with him and he outdances me every time. Honda Corporation has now taken a worker, put on an EEG helmet, and have him control the robot. So it's not possible that you can have a surrogate. This could be the future of the space program. Why is outer space not opened up for tourists? Because of a dirty, four-letter word that begins with C, cost. It costs $10,000 to put a pound of anything in near-Earth orbit. That is your weight in gold. Think of your body made out of solid gold. That's what it costs to put you in near-Earth orbit. To put you on the moon costs about $100,000 a pound. And to put you on Mars is about $1 million a pound. So you're talking about your weight in diamonds to go to the planet Mars. Why not put a surrogate? Because it's life support that makes things so expensive in outer space. You see, robots don't have to breathe. They don't have to eat. They don't bellyache. And most important, they don't have to come back. So why not put surrogates on Mars, surrogates on the moon, and you, the astronaut, can just take a breather and go into your living room and mentally communicate with a robot on the moon. This would be by far the cheapest way to have a permanent moon base. And that would be to you, the astronaut, communicating with the surrogate by radio.